Welcome back to Naked and Unique. I am going to be telling you about three different hairless breeds, and I do own all three. Here, right here with me is Smeagol. He's my American Hairless Terrier. And I guess since he's in my lap, I can just go ahead and tell you about him. Now, he is completely hairless. No hair anywhere. Not even a speck. He do have whiskers, though, a little bit. I don't know if you can see them. But they're just real short and then curly, and they're just so cute. You don't even have eyelashes. Miss your king. Okay, well, this breed originated in America, and they are terriers. So they are feisty, and, you know, they're very alert. They're playful. And that's exactly what he is. He is very feisty, but I love him. They are born with short hair. So when they first come out, they are not completely hairless. In fact, they may have, like, you know, a few patches of missing hair, but for the most part, they are completely covered in hair, and then as they grow, they lose it. And that's what happened to him. Now, there is a coated variety in this breed, meaning that they do come in short coat, so you can also get that, or you can just go down. It's pretty cool, huh? He's so sweet. I just got him not too long ago. He's my first American Hairless Terrier, and so far I am in love. Now, unlike unlike the other hairless breeds. This breed, well, he still have his baby teeth, but this breed do not lose, you know, any of their adult teeth or anything. They're not known for having missing teeth, is what I'm meaning to say. So, that's that, and I think they generally have better skin than the others. His is really smooth right now. I don't know, when they grow, you know, as they miss losing the hair, it will get a little bumpy, but it eventually go away. He still have a little bump, but overall he's really smooth. He's just so sweet. He's pretty calm a lot, but he can be very playful and, you know, you can get him going as you can with many terriers. They came about in, I can't remember exactly what year. I'm not even going to say it because I might be wrong. But the first American Hairless Terrier was born from a rat terrier litter. That's how they came about. But they eventually became separate breeds. So they're no longer the same, but they're basically like a rat terrier without hair. Pretty much. So this is this little guy, and I will move on to the next one. All right, this guy here with me is Kovu. He is a Sholowitz Squintly. I will put that down right here somewhere. Leave that, you know, show you how to spell it. Or you can just say Sholo or Mexican Hairless, you know, for short, or if it's easier for you. They come in three sizes, just like poodles: toy, mini, and standard. He's a toy, so he's the smallest. He is 10 pounds. Yes, you're 10 pounds. Now, he do have a little bit of hair here. You can see it. It's like brown on the side, and then he got his little white mohawk here. Then he have a little hair on his feet, and just a teeny little bit on his tail. Yeah, just a little on your tail. All right, sit down. All right. Now, they can also come completely hairless. He's still considered a hairless, even though he do have a little hair. But you will find some that are, like, completely naked, like, with nothing. And there's also a coated variety. They come in short coat. So that's pretty interesting as well, just like the American Hairless Terrier. You get a variety. Now, they originated from Mexico. obviously, Mexican hairless dog. And I don't, there are other hairless dogs, but out of my three, this breed do have thicker skin. So it's like a lot tougher than the other breeds, but they can still, you know, get scratches very easily. As you can see, he have a little scratch here. He's always play fight with the other dogs, and he still gets some scratches and everything. Cody, what are you doing? And this breed is known for missing teeth. He's missing two, as a matter of fact. Let me see if we can get a close up. Okay, you can see one right there. And he is missing his bottom canine right over there. So that's completely normal. I mean, nothing to freak out about if you ever, you know, get one or anything. There's some with even more missing teeth. I'm pretty sure there's some out there that have hairless, I mean, not hairless, completely just gums. That's it. But luckily he do have some teeth. let me see. This breed, they can be pretty active too, but he can be pretty chill as well. They are stubborn. I almost forgot what I was about to say. Yeah, they're stubborn, but they are trainable. So yeah, he listens. I'm not gonna say he listens pretty good, because he is hard headed, because he is stubborn, you know. He doesn't want to do what I say unless I say it like a million times. But he's trainable, which is good. He's intelligent and very alert. They're good watchdogs. They're not really into strangers that much, at least not at first. When he meets a stranger, he's like, who are you? I'm not coming by you right now, not until I get to know you a little better. So that's how he is. Say, I don't know you, so don't be all in my face, up on me. I know it. But this is the Mexican hairless, and we will get to our last dog in just a sec. I am back because I forgot one of the most interesting fact with Kovu here. Now, this breed is the oldest, if not one of the oldest, breed in the world. They are the oldest and they are the rarest. And I think that's pretty cool. And unlike most breeds, or pretty much all breeds, you know how they have genetic issues, like Chinese Crested, they're known for having eye problems. This breed isn't really known for any kind of genetic disease, but of course, you know, it varies with dog. You can still get a dog with like hip dysplasia or you know, issues with the eyes or the knees or elbows. So even though they don't have any genetic issues, if you're going to breed a dog, you still need to get them health tested and make sure that the important things are clear, which you want to cover the eyes, the elbows, the hips, the knees, and I think people test the heart too, but I'm not really too sure. But yeah, that's pretty cool, I think. So that's really it this time. I'll be back. Okay, here is Kimba, my last naked. I call him Kimba or Kim Kim or just Kim. Huh. He's so handsome. Yes, you are. All right, so he is a Chinese Crested. Not a rare dog breed like the American Hairless Terrier or the Scholex Whitney, but they're not really common either, if you get what I'm saying. Like, you will see more of this breed than the others, but they're not like a poodle or a lab. You see them like everywhere. No one really knows for sure where this breed originated from. A lot of people think Africa, some say China, and there's another place. Africa, China, Mexico. So that's three places they think that they originated from. But if you look online, you'll see more people, more websites saying Africa. So for now, I guess it's just safe to say Africa. But this breed, he is a hairless, obviously, and he's considered a true hairless, which means, you know, he have very little hair, very little. He have a little more on his tail than the others that I showed you, but he still, you know, don't have much. You can find some with a little bit longer hair or a lot more. You can look into the hairy hairless, which means that they usually have hair from here all the way here, sometimes all the way down the middle to the tail. People usually shave the back to give them a clean look, and we just leave the hair on the head, the feet, and the tail. And you can also get it in a powder puff variety, meaning long hair all over the body, not short like the other two breeds, long hair. And I do shave his little face. I will leave a picture of how he looked unshaved, maybe like over here somewhere. But I shave his face, and he do get like a little bit of fuzzies, just little fuzzies on his back, and I just shave that off to give him a better, cleaner look instead of having him looking all scruffy. Now he is, I want to say he is the most active out of my three hairless dogs, but he do know how to chill just like the other two. He is more, you know, just alive. He's just full of life, just happy. He's a lot more happy than the other two, and he will go up to any stranger looking for attention and love. Oh, Kovu, and they're all three are great snuggle buddies. I'm pretty sure it's because, you know, they're hairless and they want to stay warm, but that gives you a plus if you're looking for a little snuggle buddy. Yep. A little cuddle buddy. But I just really forgot what I was going to say. Oh, this breed is also known for having jacked up or missing teeth. His teeth aren't perfect, but he's not missing any. Let me see what side. I think it's this side. Okay, well, if you look, he have a weird little tooth down here. I don't know what the deal is with that one right there, that bottom canine. It looks like it's split, no issues or whatever, but I mean, that's something you need to expect when you're getting a hairless breed. They, except for the American Hairless Terrier, their teeth, you know, should be A-okay. But now that I've told you about the three breeds, I guess I can go ahead and squeeze in the skincare that I do. I bathe them one or two times a week, usually twice a week during the spring, summer, because unlike other dogs, they sweat. Now, you know, your normal average dog that's fully coated, they don't sweat. Maybe a little bit on their nose and under their paws, but that's really it. This breed actually sweats everywhere through their little pores, just like a human. And since they sweat, they can start to smell. So I wash them more during the summer when it's hot. And then I exfoliate their skin. I make the mix myself, and I exfoliate their skin maybe twice a month. And for moisturizer, I don't really put anything on them because they are prone to acne and blackheads, and I find that their pores get clogged up a lot more if I put something on them. So they don't really need any extra oils on their skin. They're pretty good, good diet and all that. We'll take care of that. The American Hairless Terrier, Smeagol, he do need sunscreen. Now, you can get Chinese Crested with the white or pink, whatever you want to call it, but he's dark all over. God, hold on, I'm burping. You call this color slate. He's dark all over, so I don't put any sunscreen on him. Same with Kovu. You won't really find many white sholos or anything. He do have a little bit on his foot, but not like all over their body. That's kind of look. That's people don't really breed for that look, but you can find them in this breed in American Hairless Terrier. So I haven't gotten sunscreen yet because, like I said, I just got the American Hairless Terrier, but I will be looking for safe and friendly, you know, dog friendly sunscreen, and I'll update that for all the other naked owners, naked dog owners, not naked owners. But let me see what else. What else am I missing? Yeah, you get the pimples and everything. It's actually time for their bath now. I think I pretty much covered everything I want to talk about in this video. Overall, they're all a great breed. They all have their own, you know, personality and everything. I can't say I like one more than the other, but I will say that Kimba is the most fun. Oh, your ears went up, huh? A little bit. Yeah, you are the most fun. His ears does not stand up because they were not taped as a puppy. I didn't get him at a really young age. I got him at like 6 months, which is like basically the max time you have to try to get the ears to stand. So it was pretty much too late. I got him, yeah. Yeah, they were already flopped over, so normally they would be sticking up. Hold still, Kim, let me see. Normally they'd be sticking up like this, but I mean, it's fine. He's cute with this little flop ear. This one likes to stand up sometimes. Is it this one? Or is it this one? No, yeah, there it is. It likes to stand up sometimes, so. And I think it's cute, but yeah, it's whatever. That's nothing that really bothers me. See, it gives me some character, some cute character. Okay. Thank you. Okay, well, that wraps up this video, and I really hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that you got something out of it. If you have any questions or anything about any of them, want to see a specific video or anything, or if you just want to say hi, just leave it down below in the comment section. Don't forget to rate and don't forget to subscribe. We will see you later.